Hello everyone, Adam here. Today another episode from Do-It-Yourself Electronic playlist. And today we are gonna construct a pest repellent device. So there's ongoing discussion if the ultrasonic devices that repel bugs and pests do actually work. And I've came across some researchers. As you can see on the screen, there's a research from the Kansas State University. They have tested plenty of devices and that are available on US market. And they work in the way that they generate ultrasonic sequences that target animals like rats, mice, squirrels, mosquitoes, ants, spiders, cockroaches, and other bugs. So the idea of work is that these devices generate several frequencies, set of pulses on several frequencies. As you can see, this is an example for the device named A. This is device named B. Basically, the point is that they do actually work around something like 40 kilohertz frequency. And in this episode, I will try to make our own that works exactly the same way. So if this really works, actually, they say that it works. As you can see, some of them, they are actually capable to repel some of cockroaches or fleas. As you can see, sometimes the impact is moderate. However, we're gonna see that in real life after I built one. Okay, so what do we need? We need to build a device that will actually consist of the microcontroller, power amplification module that will give actually in this scenario 2 times 3 watts of the audio output power, and set of transducers. I will use 10 of transducers. Also, there is a resistor ladder that will allow us to construct a digital to analog converter. Why do we need a digital to analog converter? Because we need to construct a sinusoidal wave, something like this, that will drive the electronic ultrasonic transducers. Okay, as you can see, I have composed this wave in an Excel. And then I have put it something like 100 times to my source code, as you can see it here. And then I send it from the program memory. I send it to the digital to analog converter output, which is actually the port B of the microcontroller ATTINY 85. So as you can see, there are some loops that send this these data that are read from the memory directly to the output. Of course, we also need some capacitors to block the distortions, and that's basically all. So the whole thing shouldn't cost you more than, I believe, $15. Okay, so let's get started.
Okay guys, I have built this device, not to bore you too much, and you can see it right here according to the diagram, and I will now show you all these parts here. Okay, so you have this PAM48 power amplification module here with output to 2 set of transducers. We have the potentiometer here, we have ATMEGA 85 here, we have 1 kilo ohm resistors, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and we have 470 ohm resistors here, 1, 2, 3, 4, and some capacitors to block the power distortions, and power lines are connected to this power amplification module right here. From the other side, there's nothing interesting, and the important thing is that that these ultrasonic transducers, they are very directional, so I had to build some kind of hedgehog, as you can see, because every transducer has only an angle of 30 or 40 degrees of sending the audio, and they are connected in the parallel. Actually, they are connected only to one of these outputs, so you can put 20 of them. I have put only 10. They are connected in parallel, all of them, to single output. And in a minute we're gonna see how it works. So I have already second device here that I have powered from 5-volt USB connector, and I will connect right now the USB power bank to show you how it's generating the signal, how the signal looks like on the oscilloscope. Right now I have connected my oscilloscope to the device, to some test pins, to the output of the digital to analog converter, and you can see the waveform that is created by this device on the oscilloscope screen. So I will magnify it a bit. Hold on. Okay, now it should be visible. So if I stop, press the stop button and try to catch, you will see that there are two frequencies. Actually, one is 42 kilohertz and the second one is something like 39 frequency, and they are combined in a set of 100 pulses. Then there is a small pulse between them. So as you can see, this is set of 8 times 100 pulses with some pauses between them. So exactly as the commercial devices are sending, as I showed you on the slides. So as you can see, I have managed to recreate the commercial device for repelling pests, and you can also do it on your own. So thank you very much. I hope you enjoyed the video. Please leave me a like and subscribe my channel. Thank you. Bye bye.